3-4 of the young kids they've got in their lineup, two again today, the Deer Park team, so that's fantastic for them. And for the, I suppose the big news for the Spotswood Football Club, Michael Fogarty, not at the Footscray Bulldogs again today. He's got duties here with Spotswood again, so that is a huge plus for the Woodsman.
That it is, and obviously in lieu of David Yaccarino being out with a groin injury too, so massive to have Fogarty still in. He played last week against Werribee District, so hopefully he can show the great form that will, well, almost be a bit ironic in a sense, see him go back to Footscray in a way if he plays well today. Greenhoff back in for Deer Park. Second best on ground for Collingwood last week against Werribee.
Yeah, it's
an impressive performance.
It's hard to work out at that level. You know, he's a young, good young player, Greenhoff. Yeah, you play a good game at VFL and they get rid of you the week after, but obviously that's the deal with the affiliated clubs with the AFL and, you know, obviously Collingwood with Collingwood and Footscray with the Western Bulldogs. So, yes, they've got plenty of players on there. Werribee District should get home there.
And another big game, Hoppers Crossing and St Albans, third versus fourth.
Got to say, we're impressed with St Albans last week. I reckon they'll give Hoppers their third loss in a row, which is going to put them now outside the top three and down about fourth spot, I think. So, Saints to get home there. Not far from away from a start here. Obviously, in the middle there, Broadbent in there with the Greenhoff will start in the ruck against the big fellow, the big bird from the Spotswood
Gus
Football
Millen.
Club. Big Gus Millen.
210 centimetre giant that he is. Did have a little bit of time on Essendon's VFL list last year.
Let's hope he doesn't get distracted like he did in round one.
Oh, it's big time. As we now get set for the opening ball up of this big top of the table clash in Division 1 of the Western Region Football League, and it's Millen who got the early tap out, but it wasn't convincing. Free kick early though, coming to Spotswood. Fogarty getting a big shove in the back, so he'll get the first possession of the day, and he's part of Willow's star player stats. Watch, there's one early for you, Willow, and he goes lateral with the kick towards right half forward. Tom Langlands is there. Boyd leads up from the back, couldn't get the mark, even though got hands to it. Quick handball inside 50, just missed a target in Pope, who now just receives it back nicely from Will Langlands, top of the square. No one home, unfortunately. Buddy Clark the target, but it's taken by Ewer. And Deer Park will look to now rebound away through the agency of Bruin. And he goes short as well. So early signs promising for Spotswood, but unfortunately execution not quite good in the last kick to Buddy Clark. Bullen up the wing. Big Gus Graham was there, but he couldn't take it. There's my man, Spiros. Didn't get the jets on that time. Just a quick little handball out to Bruin. And he's a tumbling kick along. Wasn't pretty, but they've got it back now. Spiros has got it again. Amarantides over to Cooper. And he's harassed out of it. Got a little toe poke, though, inside forward 50. It's running and running past the goal face, and Spotswood should be able to gather and go. And Will Langlands gets it. He just keeps it in two, I think, to Ryan.
No,
does he?
Out.
No. No. Thanks, Kev. Kev nearly arrived on the spot there on the boundary as the free kick goes the way of Deer Park, and they go in through Jack Burton Smith. Long driving ball, but getting back and taking the mark is Brandon Walsh for the Woodsman. Over to Elliot. We were talking to Tony Walsh earlier in the pre-game show. Very proud footballer. Hasn't had his best run in recent weeks, so we're looking for a big game from him today. Decides to go across goal with a bounce. It's slow and nice and easy as they just keep possession in the right back pocket here, Spotty.
Players right up the ground here at the moment. Woodsman high up the ground in defence.
So long kick now towards right half back. Big target there fairly. It was out number 2-1. However, the cavalry now arrive for Spotswood. A couple of chain handballs. Releases Michael Fogarty. Fogarty now goes nice and long inside 50, but it's a 2-on-1 back here now for Deer Park. Here comes Suki, the former Lion, former Spotty player. Now a Lion, but Buddy Clark really harassed him out of it nicely. Good to see pressure. Now release it out to Pope. Pope goes high to about 35 from goal.
Gee, that was high, wasn't it?
I reckon it was too, but anyway, Bullen getting back, taking the mark. Last free kick not paid by the umpire, so Bullen kicks it out to Houlihan. Houlihan, centre wing on the scoreboard side. Now a nice, lovely kick to the left half forward is a beauty. Out of Greenhoff, and now Greenhoff goes into the left forward pocket. McHarg playing deep forward in the absence of Wong. Didn't quite complete the mark over the line and out of bounds for a throw in. 3 minutes gone, no score as of yet.
He's done a lot of work early for Deer Parks there. Coach Mark Bull, and he's played right up the ground and got a couple of possessions early, but really working himself up and down the ground at the moment. A lot of gut running at the moment from the old veteran.
And he's down right at this contest as we speak too, Tomsy.
Yep. It's really, really worked out. Good matchup down there too. Well, Quick was on Boardy. Boardy's pushed up the ground at the moment. No, Quickie's still gone down with Murray Board. So good matchup there, those two.
On the tap down, Purton Smith lurk in, but he's brought down. And what's the umpire decided
free
here?
Kick, I think.
He's going to give a free kick to Purton Smith for a crew tackle in the end. So the first meaningful shot on goal going the way of Deer Park through JPS.
Yeah, he's had a great season too. Jack Purton Smith, really every game consistent. So I reckon he'll be right up there with the votes at this time of the year, just after the halfway mark. The umpire's votes.
Okay, for his middle favourite, I would dare say. You're right there, Tomsy. So Purton Smith, who's averaged 2 goals a game this season, amongst plenty of disposals as well. Can he keep that average nice with a goal here? No. One behind only. That is the opening score.
Tell what, they've worked hard, Spotswood, inside to get it up inside their 50 for the ones. But Deer Park just sort of settling, even at this early, nearly 5 minutes into this first quarter, just sort of settling a little bit at the moment.
So the kick-out duties, courtesy of Knight for the Woodsman, and they get it out not too prettily, unfortunately, out of defence, but they do find touch over the line and out of bounds for a throw-in just in front of Brandon Walsh, centre wing on the scoreboard side. It's an excellent coming out of defence for Spotswood, but they'll take it though. Gus Graham in the ruck against Greenhoff. Greenhoff gets first position on his far, though, as Tom Langlands gets a hurried right foot kick as it spirals its way towards the line again. Kept in nicely though by Nathan Dumbledon. Good work. Arasti's opponent out of it. Really worked underneath him and got a nice kick to touch inside 50 out for a throw in. Good result for Spotswood.
Yeah, it is. Just they've got to keep it in there. They've got to trap it in there now. This is where your Will Langlands, Pope, these type of players, they've got to work their backsides off to keep it inside their 50 now, no matter what happens with this 50-50.
On the throw in, about 45 out from the Spotswood goal. Third man up was Quick, but only spotty players there at the fall of the ball. The handball comes back out here to Marks. Marks centres it in. Buttigieg Clark to target, but the height factor there not working for him. Will Langlands at the back. No, actually, it was Pope. Didn't get the right boot to it, unfortunately. And as a result, Deer Park are able to clear it away, or will they? Leading out from the front, Houlihan had two to beat and then just controlled it nicely to get the handball to Greenhoff. He's switching kick towards the Social Club side.
Well done, Elliot.
Execute nicely at all. Well, Elliot able to cut it off. Over to Norton now. Norton's kick in board. Pope takes the mark. 30 out from goal, directly in front.
Been lively up there. Pope been involved in a little bit. As I said, probably had once again an interrupted pre-season at the start of the year with cricket commitments and being involved, played a lot in the reserves up to this stage. But he makes a big difference. He's been a quality player for years, Popey, and part of the successful era that he had Spotswood, 7 or 8 years ago. It'll be a big start for them if you can get this one through, Pope.
Has been welcomed back through the reserves last couple of weeks and put 3 goals through. Can he add his first senior goal for the year now? He has. Good start for the Woodsman. Very encouraging start psychologically. 1-6, the Deer Park one behind.
Yeah, look, good, great delivery too inside there from that midfield there. Good work by Elliott before, just that interception and run to carry with the ball. But good delivery inside. They went up the corridor there. Pope was the third in line there, but read the play well. And he's strong. The secret is with Pope too, he's strong overhead. And it's something they're looking. They're starting a pretty small forward line in Buttigieg Clark and Pope deep inside their 50. Obviously, Boydie further up the ground with Will Langlands. But that's a good little matchup. And at the moment, it's probably just worrying the Deer Park defence at the moment, because both are strong overhead.
So back in the middle, Millam missed the first opportunity at a tap out, but got the second one not okay. Fortunately, didn't get it to advantage. Hot ball now, Marks and Will Langlands get in and apply a nice tackling to hold up the Deer Park charge out. Summers the last man with the footy. As we go again, Millam with that massive reach over the top of Greenhoff, but it spills out now to Bruin. Bruin the right half forward, the kick is good too. And the mark taken, Kwame, right in front.
Just trying to pick up who's got the matchup on McCarg at the moment. He's obviously in scintillating form from last Saturday and already had a couple of touches on the board, on his stat sheet. Just can't pick it up who is at the moment. We'll grab it for you in a sec. But I'll tell you what, he's been a live wire. I'd still believe with not having Wong or Kondos in that forward line, it gives McCarg a lot more freedom to be the main man.
So in he comes. Distance won't be a problem. Has got a bit of an angle to work with, but it's a lovely kick off the boot. Nothing phases Kwame McCarg at all. Goal. And the quick reply coming the way there for Deer Park. 1-1-7 to Spotswood, 1-6.
Just Willow, this early piece, nearly at the 9-minute mark. Just the inside 50s for both sides.
Inside 50, Spotswood 5, Deer Park 4.
Okay, pretty even at the moment. A couple of marks either end. Pope with that one, McCarg there. So pretty even. Good game, good open game of football at this early stage. The movement from both sides is good. The spread's been good. Both sides are prepared to work hard with their run and their spread out wide at the moment.
Number 16's picking up, Kwame.
That would be Sam Wood.
Yep.
Who's got the job there. Thanks, Kev. As we go back into the middle, Milam again with Greenhoff. Greenhoff, though, got the better position that time to get the tap down. Not to advantage, though. It's a hot footy still inside the middle. But now Deer Park with the loose crumb, courtesy of Ismail. Gets it out to right half forward. McCann can target again, but Wood gets the spoil in and then follows up nicely with the footy two to put that perceived pressure on Dean Stankovic and sees the ball over the line and out of bounds. And out the full, though, I think inherently came off the boot of Stankovic. So free kick to Spotswood. Very lucky.
Well done, Sam Wood there. Good work.
So the Woodsman going backwards to go forwards here. They'll switch play around. There's Brandon Walsh wearing the 25. Short ball here. Target was Ryan, but he has it thumped away from him over the line and out of bounds.
Gee, they're keen to switch all the time, Spotty, aren't they, Tomsey?
Yeah, and how good's that? How good's that to see? I mean, this is a Spotswood. We know that they've got to do. They've got to take everything ahead of them today. They've got to run. They've got to switch. They've got to spread. Take every risk you can. This is about character today, win, lose, or draw.
So from the throw-in, out the back. Deer Parker able to get it away. Through plant.
Free kick,
but it's
I think.
A free kick being paid earlier. It's not no advantage.
He's going to bring it back, is he?
Yeah, it's coming back.
Okay.
Or is it going to go downfield? No. Well, we can't want it. No, we'll go back now to young Craig Plant. For his third senior game. 20-year-old, and he shorts it to Jordan Purton Smith. Jack Purton Smith, who goes for home. Has he got the carry? I think he has too. Good goal. Very loose checking there from Spotswood, where they'll be dirty on themselves to let Purton Smith loose like that. 2-1-13 to 1-6, Deer Park by 7 points. 10.5 gone.
Split second lack of concentration. It's all a take for an opposition to stop when Purton Smith's got the ball in his hands, and that's what Spotswood did then. He took the mark, they just took their eyes off him for a sec, and he was away. You've got to concentrate 110% on a player like Purton Smith right from the time the ball's in his area. Do not take your eyes off him or the ball around him.
Greenhoff with the early leap, but Gus Millen just stood there stationary and still got the tap out. However, the follow-up ball didn't get out of the middle. It's a ball up. Bit of wrestling going on there, including with the umpire, who was able to wrestle out himself to throw it up. Nice work. Summers gathers a loose footy, then kicks it high. Didn't look at all. And as a result, he has turned it over.
Oh.
And speaking of turnover, that's exactly what Spots would have done right there. Straight back to young Plant. Just on the edge of the centre square on the scoreboard side. That's high. Wants Cooper to take it.
Nice.
If you're going to back anybody to take a contested mark with a ball that high, Daniel Cooper would be your man.
Yeah, good work, Daniel Cooper. Really was an up-and-under kick from young Plant there, but Daniel Cooper got that front position and was not going to lose it. So good grab there. That's another little area where they've just got to be careful. The spots of defence got to be a little bit stronger body-wise than that. Don't let Cooper get around to that front position.
One of the more unheralded heroes for the Deer Park side, Cooper. He really hooked that left. Didn't bend back all that much, just the one behind. Score now 2-2-14 for Deer Park and Spotswood 1-6. And after they worked valiantly to get that goal through Pope, it's been all Deer Park since that 6.5 minute mark. Let's see what the Woodsman can do here to rebound as the kick comes in to young Ryan. So Nicholas Ryan wanted to come down the centre wing on the scoreboard side, didn't like the options up forward, so he goes back instead to Knight in the right back pocket.
Instructed to go at all costs here, Spotswood. They really can't afford to be just playing in the hands of Deer Park right now. They're just going to push numbers up the ground here, Deer Park.
They're still stuck in their right back pocket here, Spotswood, and they're going to come back now to the right half back area.
Forces
and
an error.
And
forces an
the
error. You know, the young fellow there, he had the football, he had to go. He had to go right from the start, Ryan. As soon as he got it, take off. Take the risk. He had open players on this wing side, the outside wing of the ground here. He had to take the risk, and that's what they've got to do all the time. Otherwise, they're just going to get those numbers back and flood it and zone right up here, Deer Park.
So a couple of short kicks in, Purton Smith, and now Crawford on the left into the middle of the ground. Good kick too to Max Bruin, playing more up the ground. in the early minutes of this game. Bruin.
Stewart's
high
on
high kick. Wants Chris Stewart. Wants the captain. Cooper comes in from the side as well. Couldn't take the mark. At the fall of the ball, spotty players are in number and they can get it away.
This is good. Got to go. Got to go.
And they've got their opportunity now through Seamus Tippett. And they get it up towards that centre wing on the social room side as players now flood back.
Yeah, backwards again, though.
But to get Clark.
Not to go for it.
Then good work to Elliott, but they've got to work overtime now to get it forward. They've got numbers up there now. Now they've got to come forward.
Wood has it in the middle. Goes with two on one. Brandon Walsh takes it. The other one was Ryan, who ensured that Plant couldn't quite get to the marking contest there. And now he uses Fairley. So Lachlan Fairley, centre wing on the scoreboard side now. Boyd presenting a target, but Greenhoff getting back in the hole. Quick there with him as well. Pass is a little short to Nathan Dumbledon, but not great whatsoever. And young Plant did very well. Kept his head up, and he cut that one off. His kick in board goes towards a little live wire here in Mayum, who sees the goals, then gets run down, gets the handball away, around about 15 out. Spotswood players, though, getting back frantically. And now Knight has the opportunity to get it away. His handball over to Fogarty, and Fogarty can now turn and go. And they've got the spare man out on centre wing on the social side. And the kick now comes in. Pope at the back. But it was too short. Fullan gets back to fill the hole. Off to Ewa. Ewa's long kick up the centre wing is sensational to Houlihan. Houlihan's kick just as exquisite towards Stewart at the feet.
Easy.
Cooper goal.
Too easy.
Snap. Bang. Vintage Deer Park there with that play. 3-2-20 to Spotswood, 1 straight 6, 15 gone in the first term.
Don't mind Spotswood playing this bit of a holding on to a possession game of the football, but there's a time when you've got to go forward, and twice now over the last 5 minutes they've gone backwards, fine. They've brought it across to the other side, fine. All of a sudden, then you've got to go. They had forwards up there. They had the numbers pushed back into their attack, but they've held on it. They've got that one kick two extra, and twice it's been turned over. Deer Park are going to make them pay. To put Deer Park under pressure, they've got to try and run him as well. Take him on, run through the lines when they've got possession of the football and carry it.
Oh, good reach from Greenhall to get it down to Purton Smith. Purton Smith goes towards Cooper. Just wrestled out of it by Fairley, who did nicely. Fell on all fours, but still got the handball away. Off to Wood, and Wood's careful left foot kick is okay too, and Spots will retain possession on the left half back flank. Ball comes in the middle, wasn't pretty at all. Gives a chance for Plant here to get onto it again. Tried to tap it towards Ewa, didn't succeed with it. Coming through there is Spencer Davis. Didn't get the footy himself either. And eventually the umpire calls for a ball up. Umpires today, Thomas Harrison, Dean McGowan and Greg Dennison around the field. Jordan Wiltshire and Phil Paul Parker on the boundary. And
free
Mitchell
kick Teller, here, free kick
Kingswell
here,
and goals. As a free kick gets picked out from that stoppage. Spotswood's way.
Run.
Now's the time they've got to go. They've got to go and go quick.
Jeez, they're frustrating to watch.
Stationary again. Buttigieg Clark at the back, but it was Dumbledon eventually who gets the footy. Nathan Dumbledon gets a bit of a shepherd from the captain in Boyd. Probably not enough, though. He's still being corralled a bit. Eventually now finds some room. Wanted Pope, but Pope wasn't expecting the footy at all. Easy ball to spoil out of bounds for Stankovic. Comedy of errors for Spotswood in the early going.
Just turning their back on the play, a few of them, two at the moment. The Woodsman.
So the throw in. Now Boyd up in ruck. Got it down to Norton. Norton's kick half smothered. Chance for Fogarty, who was a little bit bamboozled by the footy. Eventually goes back after it.
Good
held
contest
up though by Crawford. And now the bodies all come in and force the ball up 55 out from the Spotswood goal. But nice ferocity shown from both sides.
Yeah, great contest, Michael Fogarty. Really eyes for the football only then. That was good work. Also from Broadbent too, in and under.
Boyd up to Stewart this time. Pope charges through, breaks through Summers. Didn't break through Stewart though. Umpire call play on. And eventually the ball gets thrown over and out and whacks the caravan too. Out in front of Stankovic and Broadbent. So throw in. Still 55 out from Spotswood's goal. They trail this by 14 points. 17.5 gone opening term. Tap down is won by Broadbent. His left foot kick in the middle. That's a free kick to Deer Park. Mayum drag down. Advantage paid. Out the back, is it? No.
It's going to go to McCarg.
Kwame.
See, away. Straight away. He was away then, and that's something Spotty aren't doing.
Fortunate thing, though, he was the man on the mark wasn't quite ready. He was off there. But anyway, he still finds a target, though, with a switching play, McCarg. However, that follow-up kick wasn't so good, and Spotswood have regained possession here.
I'm a big fella. Oh,
through
run.
Wood. Oh. Milham, the target. The ball bouncing just in front of him. He couldn't trap it at all. Now trying to come through at the back was Matthew Dumbledon. He couldn't get it either. And Deer Park should be able to clear away here. Plenty of numbers. Corey Brown has the mark at right half back, and he shorts it to Broadbent. So Broadbent just waiting a little bit. Still wants to go, though. Still wants to hurry. Unfortunately, though, the kick wasn't so great. The options weren't there. Went over the head of Summers. Mark taken by Ryan. Short ball in now. Boyd has it. Yeah. Almost go the journey from here.
Slow movement again, though, by Spotswood.
Yeah, you got the big fella, big Gus down there. All right, he might not mark it. Get it up to him. Get someone front and square, but they've gone sideways again. Deer Park now getting back into the hole. Rolling it back.
That one's short ball. Tip at the target. Was right behind it. But eventually got the handball over to Marks. And Marks has got the goal. Wasn't pretty, but they got there, Tomsey, in the end.
Yep.
So 2-12 to 3-20. With the way this game's been going, all 90 minutes of it, you'll take it if you're Spotswood.
Look, they're not playing bad football either. Woodsman, make no mistake. It's just that I think they're just caught in that line or that area where they don't know whether to go for break a little bit or hold on to it. Obviously, the instructions are to just hold it, you know, chip it around a little bit, hold it, frustrate Deer Park a little bit if need be. But then that time to go is the time you go 110%. You know, that goal then to Marks will give them a lot of confidence. So, a good game of football. Great game of football.
Good finish there to Jason Marks getting that goal as Spotswood get the next clearance from the centre. Off hands. Well read by the former woodsman in Suki. And his short ball is okay too to Bruin. And now he goes down to Purton Smith, centre wing on the social club side. And Purton Smith is off. He'll take on Jason Marks with two bounces. Now drives the ball to right half forward. Marking target Bullen. Got hands to it, but that was all. And then he goes up to ground and is brought to ground. The umpire will call for a ball up.
Jack Purton-Smith up there, seven disposals, four marks and a goal.
Just a carry too. Carry with a football. He would have covered, you know, another kilometre, I reckon, at this stage.
Boyd up in ruck this time against Cooper. Boyd got the tap down over towards Marks, who goes to a 2-on-3 here favouring Deer Park. But Will Langlands did quite all right to create enough of a even contest. Marks then follows up his handball back to Will Langlands, cut off by Broadbent, who couldn't trap the footy cleanly. It eludes him and over the line for a throw-in.
That was only a guess too, Willow, that when I said kilometre. I really haven't got a tracker. I only made that up.
Yeah,
you're probably right, though, the way that Purton Smith's been.
You don't have a
year.
Computer, so I wouldn't expect you to have a GPS.
I haven't got a real phone either. I haven't got anything that you men have got, modern men.
As the ball comes to left half forward for Spotswood. Nice work from Tippett. Took the game on.
Is it go?
Now they've got half an opportunity here.
Good.
Mark taken. Fogarty. Short ball. Should go all right too. But again, Clark gets
should be
back.
50.
And a push down after
Dennison.
He took it.
Dennison was on it.
Easy thinking, Greg
Dennison. Oh, should have
He's left it. It was late.
It's played on.
But it might not matter for Buttergate Clark. He decides to go on and snap. Oh, it does in the end.
That's
behind.
That's disappointing. That is disappointing. He could have gone back. Great work by Tommy Langlands there, too, just before. But Buttergate Clark, that's what you earn your dollars for, mate. You've got to kick those ones.
I think one mistake by the umpire there.
Yep, correct.
The score now 2-1-13 spots with 3-2-20 Deer Park into time on now the first term as the ball's brought to the left half back and wing area on the scoreboard side. Chris Stewart has the mark. Now just calling for the troops to just fade left. They didn't quite hear him unfortunately in the end. Spotswood get the mark back. And it was Fairley who got it and now short ball in, Wood. Oh, that was a shank off the boot. Didn't get in the air at all. Ryan Crawford says thank you, gathers it, and then sends it nice and long up into the Greenhoff direction. Now at the fall of it, Bullen just bullocks his way through. Houlihan was caught, then got away, caught again. Got the handball out to Crawford. Crawford sweeping handball over to Purton Smith. Purton Smith can go to Cooper. Well, he wanted him, but then the teammate got in the way there. I think it was Vella who chipped in. Still a live ball. But gathering it back now here is Summers. Goes for goal. It was a flat ball, but Hark there the target. And it'll be a free kick coming here to Deer Park, I think, for a coat hanger.
I reckon.
Crude as.
As crude as can be. And it'll be Amarantides to take it. My man Spiros.
Yeah, young Spiros. Tell you, he's cemented a spot in this side, as young Ewers has as well. And this is probably the most exciting thing for Deer Park at this stage of the year. The youngsters that are coming through aren't just filling in holes, aren't just getting a bit of a chance. They've taken the chance and they've cemented themselves a spot. Unless something goes critically wrong over the next 10 to 12 weeks, they should be playing finals.
So Spiros Amarantides, 18 goals for the season. Can he make it 19 here? No, he's pushed it right and it'll be one behind only. So 3-3-21 now, Deer Park. They lead it by 8 points. So Spotswood 2-1-13, playing better football in the last few minutes. 23 1/4 gone here in this first term.
Their chances, haven't they, boys? The Spotswood going forward, even, you know, that last miss by Buttigieg Clark without half dwelling on it too much. I mean, that would have really given them that momentum coming into this quarter time break.
Great mark.
So the kick comes out, and it was a great mark too. By Marks, who now goes long. Pope, the target. Unfortunately, height one out there. Stankovic takes the mark in front, and he wastes no time getting it to Houlihan on centre wing, the scoreboard side. And Houlihan wastes no time either to get it to left half forward.
Nice
promising build up again. Burton Smith once more. And his short ball in finds Summers, who's pretty dangerous with the footy as well, although that one wasn't so great to Brown. It clean bowled him, and he's opposite 26, and Boyd gathers it. Nice gather too for a big man. Just well floats it up the top. Gave it an opportunity there for Farley, and you know, didn't take the mark still. Eyes for it. His opponent pushed him in the front. Free kick.
Well done, Brad Farley. First game. That was good. Good work.
Short to Nathan Dumbledon, who now sends it nice and high. Pope getting there, but he's outnumbered. Suki gets back, takes the mark, and they're away here at Deer Park. Drew Val up. Off to Cooper. No, that's one he normally eats for breakfast there. Didn't take it at all. Still time to gather and go. Sweeping handball over the top to Summers is okay. Luke Summers now can steady on that right boot. End up getting a little bit rushed in the end, though. Probably thought he had too much time. McHarg out number 2-1 at left half forward. Spotswood get the rebound. Clean bowls one. Didn't clean bowl Butler, and he allowed Will Langlands to gather it. However, his handball was chopped off. They gather it again here, Deer Park. Summers and Brown combine. Off to Cooper. Cooper a hurried kick to left half forward. In the battle here, oh, it's David and Goliath there. Vella being David up against Big Fairley. In the end, though, Spotswood win that contest, and they get the ball.
Got to go harder than that.
Out towards Davis, but he's outmarked. And once again, Deer Park with an opportunity. Ewer with the footy. Called to play on now through the centre of the ground. Goes towards centre half. Forward. Oh, good leap. McHarg was out number 2-1. Got good hands to it. Play on, though. In the middle.
That high tackle.
There's a free kick going to Spotswood here.
Going to Fogarty.
And it'll go against Amarantidi, so Michael Fogarty to take it.
Got to open up. Got to move this forward line now. Got to get it a little bit open. Boydie's gone out wide, but Fox might come out this far side. No. Sort of go to the club
side. Goes to left half forward. Boyd is the target. Got to the front, but then was out-muscled. Bruin and quick combine. Now Bruin follows up. And Rantides gets in nice and low. Two against Boyd. Almost gave a free kick for taking out the legs. But then he gathers himself up nicely. Recomposes and gets away. Kick towards Cooper. Got his Dukes to it, didn't complete the mark. At the fall of it, Fairley's handball wide towards Spiros once more.
Greenhoff.
And Greenhoff on the siren.
Is it touched?
Has got
it. Home?
Through. Not touched. Goal to Scott Greenhoff. Interesting. Could it have been, Tomsey?
Oh, I don't know. The Spotswood players were appealing for it, but not to be.
No.
It's gone through. What a snap right on the siren by the big fella, big
Brilliant
Greenhoff.
Brilliant gather out of all players, the huge ruckman for the Lions. Had a sensational game, as we mentioned in the Collingwood VFL last week. He's brought that form back in with that gathering goal, as good as a rover can do. And at
1 point, Werribee Districts 4-5-30. That's all we've got through from Division 1 at the moment.
Thank you, Kev, as we get started here in the second term. And the Rucks go at it. Bit of a stalemate, but Deer Park now threatening through Ismail. They get the clearance eventually up towards Cooper. Good fist away, though, by Lockie Fairley. Now it's in front of the Deer Park goals, about 30 out, and then a couple of crucial fumbles in the end. You just can't do that in defence. Bullen says thank you and then snaps a goal. Oh, heartbreaking. 5-3-33-2-1-13. Barely a second gone, second term.
Yeah. That is a fumble that you look back on, you don't want to see again. He's been good, Mark Bullen. This quarter, as I said, he worked in the first 10 minutes of the game. He really worked up and down the ground a fair bit. But inside their 50 then, Christian Elliott playing a bit of an unfamiliar role across that half-back line at the moment, trying to get himself into a bit of confidence, a bit of form. But you can't fumble back there, chicken, when you're down that back line. Otherwise, you're just going to swoop on it back there. Interesting structure. They've got up forward 2D Parker Houlihan, who I think's had a serviceable first quarter, also starting inside the 50.
And it rains and pours for Elliott as we get a restart. Deer Park again threatening, but through the combination of Norton and Orchard, Spotswood are able to get it away. However, the kick up towards Boyd didn't find its target. Quick takes the mark and wastes no time to get it to Bullen. Feels just like a teenager again, the way he's been moving around today.
It does.
Mark Bullen.
So what do you like to hear that too,
absolutely,
the old veteran. He is
former
playing a very good game.
Former Essendon AFL listed player, of course, last decade as he shorts that one. Now to Broadbent, who got it from Perton Smith initially. So on centre wing, right on the boundary line, scoreboard side. It's a pretty read for Deer Park at the moment by 20 points. Cooper leads fairly to the ball here, right half forward. Too far out to score though, Daniel Cooper. So he looks to go short. It's a careful kick too. And this young kid's had an impressive game so far. Plant. He'll use Cooper again. Just the required 15. Probably again still a bit too far out. He's about 60 from goal. That kick was an absolute shambles though. Went about 14 and a half. No Deer Park player in sight. Fogarty gathers it and goes to a 2-on-1 though, favouring Deer Park. So that explains that last few seconds. Dumbledon the man for Spotswood. Couldn't beat the two Deer Park players and they eventually get it away to Broadbent, but he couldn't complete the mark over the line and out of bounds, and Michael Knight makes sure he knows about that.
Gee, I don't know where he's going there, Coops. It's just a real miskick.
For a brain fade?
Mm.
So throw in, centre wing, scoreboard side. Greenhoff tried to really cup that one up to a teammate. Didn't succeed at all. Now Marks gets at the back. Quick handball away, but Bruin, good tackle on him. Forced a turnover. Quick once more. His handball, though, set his teammate up for failure in Perton Smith. Good tackle by young Josh Norton. Part of the Spotswood under 18 premiership side last year.
Bit high willow, do you reckon? Or
just no, I thought Perton Smith took him on. It's a good tackle,
fair enough. Good call.
Had for opportunity as Norton goes short. Marking target part again. Clark, probably beaten again for height there as it's fisted away out for a throw in.
And around the ground, boys, Sunny Heights 117, Wyndham Vale 6238.
So throw in just inside Spotswood's forward 50. And the ball is brought down. It's a Spotswood clearance coming up here by Nathan Doubleton, who centres it in nicely too.
Beautiful kick.
And the mark has been taken, and Spotswood, you think this time they won't go the way that Buttigieg Clark did in that first turn when he had that shot from about 15 out and then snapped it and missed. Nicholas Ryan, you should just go back for a drop punt.
He's been all right, Ryan, Nicholas Ryan, in this first quarter and a bit. Tell you what, he finishes, he kicks this one. It's a bit of pushing and shoving going on behind play there. Comes in Ryan. And
it's pushed left. It was on target, then it just drifted last second for a behind. But he has had a good bit of it so far. Plenty of the ball around that early few minutes of the first term down back. 2-2-14, plays 5-3-33. Margin now at 19 points.
Something going on here. The umpire, umpire's caught it back. He might have gone over the line here.
And I think that is what the call has been too, Tomsey. Good pick up.
Is that another point?
Or is it...
What happened then?
I don't know. Cole Umpire's waved the flag for a point.
Yeah.
And there's another kick in.
Or did he not finish the...
Well, it doesn't matter.
Mustn't have finished the flags.
Doesn't matter anyway.
Confusion everywhere.
We'll check that score in half-time anyway. I'm going to stick with 2-2-14 as the ball is brought to right half-back for Deer Park. Quick gets it long. Houlihan at the back. Can't beat Boyd, though.
That's good. They've got to get him in the game. He's got to get in this game. Murray Boyd round the ground a little bit. This is a focal point up forward for the Spotswood team.
Oh, it has to go backwards though. It's a fairly, probably not the desired result for the captain, but they maintain possession anyway, Spotswood. And fairly now crosses it into Sam Wood. And Wood switches over to the social side. Dangerous kick, but Ryan made it look good.
Yeah,
well done, Nick Ryan. Short ball into Elliott. Elliott now to a 2-on-1. Didn't do any favours for his teammate up the ground. Ryan, though, great follow-up. Unfortunately, couldn't get the handball out to the coach in Tom Langland's turnover. Houlihan has it at left half forward for Deer Park. Burton Smith, short ball in, and Kwame's got it.
A lot different when you move the ball quicker, isn't it? The way that Deer Park ran the ball there was fantastic.
Yeah, the low, coming in low too, you know. Burton Smith just head over the football there, lowered the eyes, got it out in front of McCarg. Wood had no chance of getting it out of the hands of Kwame McCarg then.
Three possessions for Spotty then, and they went backwards 30 yards. Three possessions for Deer Park, and they're kicking for goal.
Yeah.
That's been the story of the day so far, as McCarg comes in for his second. He's 24th of the season. He likes it, and he's got it. He's on the angle, but no angle phases, Kwame McCarg. Two goals and six overall now for Deer Park. 6-3-39 to Spotswood 2-2-14.
Spotswood, look, they're winning enough of the ball, Spotswood. They're just not using it, not finishing, I suppose. Ryan, if you had kicked that one before, you know, they're a little bit closer and the momentum's going their way a little bit. But this this chipping across, holding onto the ball across this half-back line, as I say, there's a time to do it. Yes, go for it. But then you've got to go. You've got to explode and go forward. And at the end, they're going to be looking up and thinking, gee, we haven't had much impact onto the scoreboard. We've had a lot of the football, but had no impact on the scoreboard. And in the end, that's what wins your game, the scoreboard.
Early lead there for Greenhoff. Pretty much took Millam out of that contest, but didn't get it to advantage. Still a hot footy in the middle. And the umpire will call it back.
Yeah, with the no real centre-half forward target for Spotswood, that's when they should be moving the ball quicker.
Yes, yeah, yep.
This time Millam gets a better position. Easy tap down for him. Eventually it's taken away by Norton. Quick hurried right foot kick to centre-half forward. More in hope than anything else. Gathered by Tippett. Handball as well in hope to Big Boyd. Now to Marks. Marks, oh, he has showed the dummy for the handball. Now sees the open goals and goes for it. And no, didn't get there. In the end, rushed over for a behind. Good desperation work by Tim Quick in the end. So 2-3-15 to 6-3-39 the score.
Maliki Clark's down. He ran into the goalpost. Doesn't look good. His arm, right arm, looks like.
Oh, yep, you're right.
Oh, he's in trouble.
Trainer's out to him now as Deer Park quickly get the ball up towards right half forward. Houlihan gathers it, turns, spears it. Oh.
Lovely.
Oh, breathtaking. Lovely. Mark that.
Oh, I think Buttigieg Clark's in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, he's still down.
He's not up. Yeah.
Ouch.
Remember that Westgate end. Still on his on all fours. Buttigieg Clark hands the trainers now.
Right, the Sangalier with McCark right in front of our commentary box here.
Get the best view of it, Tomsey.
I tell you what, he'll make sure he'll kick this one because he knows the camera's on him.
Another 45-degree right angle. Look at that!
Knows it's home.
Right in front. Beautiful. Of the camera, and you can watch it again and again and again on. Beautiful. WRFL TV. That'll be in the June highlights package, Kirsty. Mark that one down for me later. That's a third one for McHarg. 7-3-45 to 2-3-15.
Looks like they're taking Buttigieg Clark off on the other side of the ground, which means he's not coming through the interchange gates, which I would suspect would mean something's broken.
Yeah, I reckon that arm be broken. I'd sort of seen that. Play hit the goalpost. I didn't know it was Buttigieg Clark, but you picked it up, Willow. He really must have crunched into that pretty hard. Okay, thanks, Willow. See you soon.
Oh, he's so awestruck by his hard work. He's speechless, Tomsey. But it's a huge blow, too, just in all seriousness, for Spotswood to see Buttigieg Clark go off. As Deer Park get another clearance, Houlihan quick to go. Another spearing kick. McHarg again, this time a little bit too high for him. The gathering ball, though, missed by Orchard. Spiros gets the goal. And the assist coming from Kwame. And they light up McLean Reserve with that lovely goal there. The Lions doing it all easily at the moment. 8-3-51 to 2-3-15.
You there, Willow?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, good. The beauty of Kwame McHarg is, I mean, he's a goal kicker. We can run through a midfield, but he can mark. He's a strong mark overhead. The goal that he kicked just before, Sam Wood put that much body pressure onto him, and he held his ground, kept that front position, and leaped. And all of a sudden, 3 minutes later, he's a goal assist by tapping it into young Spiros in the goal square. Just too hard to keep out of the game. He's in rich form.
So from the centre stoppage, Tom Langlands gets to Fairley. He goes towards Orchard, who just stood there in awe in that last one because he was the man in the meat in that sandwich between Spiros and Kwame before. And he's now over on centre wing, tapping that over the line for a throw-in.
Straight in the room, Spuddigieg Clark.
Very fierce for his rest of the day, I think, as Spotswood get the clearance from the throw-in.
We'll good kick, too.
Jeez, that was a good kick off the ground, that.
Who was that? Orchard, I think. Jai Orchard.
It was, yeah.
So, good men's making there for Orchard as the kick now comes in towards Pope. Playing for the free, and has he got it?
Yeah, I think he dropped that one.
No, illegal disposal.
Yeah.
Good call, Tomsey. Free kick to Deer Park. Houlihan, once again, on his own.
It's been good today, Houlihan.
He's been real good.
He's been loving this scoreboard wing side, too, getting plenty of disposals on that area. Now Broadbent, former Barry Priest medalist. Played with the Tatura Bulldogs last year. Back in the Lions colours this year. Goes towards Greenhoff, outnumbered 4-1 here. And he almost beat them all. But in the end, though, Brandon Walsh just got a nice little side shove. Allowed Elliott to gather the loose footy. Short ball in's an absolute woeful kick to Boyd. towards his shins. He has to go to ground. Young Akat Mayum holding him up, and holding him up ferociously too. Like a bulldog, just did not give up on that. Saw it like a bone and kept on gnawing at him.
Spots, we've got to be careful here that the floodgates don't open.
Yes. It's
getting very close in the...
Yep.
40 out from Deer Pass, goal, Greenhoff. Exquisite tap down the broad bank. Didn't gather it, unfortunately, in the end. Burton Smith goes in there. Tom Langlands has him. And we'll get another ball up, but it's closer to Deer Park's goal. About 30 out now.
Christian Elliott, he's obviously out of sorts. I just say, you just work and work and work and work. Chicken, keep at it. It'll come back.
Greenhoff's tap was to the right spot too, and Norton was there, though, to read it for Spotswood. However, his rebounding kick, not great. Deer Park once again with an opportunity and a short ball. Bullen's got it. And he's directly in front, 45 out, and he should go back and get his second here.
Difference too, Willow, that when they're going forward, they're running hard into the hole, Deer Park. We're up the other end, spots when they have gone forward. They're ambling along to try and receive the ball going in forward, where Deer Park, Mark Bullen's been excellent today in that area, really running hard to the contest or past the contest to open it up behind him for his teammates.
Said he'd been working on his fitness, didn't he?
Yeah.
So Bullen, has he got the distance here? No. Off hands on the last line. Ball still in play. Here's a chance. Mayum, can he gather? Can he twist? Can he turn? Can he snap? No, he got the banana kick in. Didn't get a bend on it, though. Still in play, and eventually it's out of the bounds, courtesy of Brad Farley for Spotswood. Left forward pocket for the Lions. And you're right, Willow, these floodgates, they are ready to burst open. As we get the feel now, 13 minutes gone in the second term. Margin at 36 points, the way of the Lions. Fogarty gets the clearance here for Spotswood, goes high and long, wants Gus Millam. Outnumbered 3-1 here. And Deer Park, the numbers win out.
It's going to be a contest. He's kicking
Boardwell one-on-one. Both players at eyes only for the footy. Still a 50-50 ball here. It was Wood who eventually got it for Spotswood towards Ryan.
Great tackle, Spiros.
Didn't get anywhere at all with that. Amarantides brought him down. Actually, it was Tippett. We got that ball from his teammate Wood, but Spiros got him.
Just watch the leads here. They're strong leads from... he's going to go short here first, Spiros.
Summers.
But the rest are strong, hard leads to open up. You've got Greenhoff down there. Cooper's pushed right out wide. Bullen again pushes up into that hole. They're creating space for themselves, Deer Park, inside their... We're going forward towards the inside of their 50 here, creating space.
The beauty here is that Bullen has used Cooper as well.
It's confidence too, what they've got. Playing with confidence, the Lions.
Goes Bullen again. Oh! Got hands to it, then copped a nice little whack in the head. Lets the umpire know about it. Greg Dennison. Dennison says, no, it was a fair spoil.
Mark Bullen's had four disposals this quarter. Daniel Cooper's had the five as well.
It's against Elliott that time, but Greg Dennison allowing that one to go on. Throw in. Cooper and Boyd up in ruck, and now Bullen sharks it. Handball out to Cooper. Oh, good little give over the top to Broadbent. However, Michael Fogarty was onto it. Now Ishmael runs through. Tackled by Fogarty. Back to Broadbent. Broadbent's quick kick. Spiros Amarantides at the back. Read it beautifully. And he'll take the shot from the left forward pocket. Should be good enough for a drop punt, but with Spiros, you know that it could be any kind of magic here.
Gee, they're strong in the bodies, strong in their core bodies, Deer Park. Hold their ground very, very well.
So Amarantides now to come in. Orchard there, ready for the snap. Or was he? He was walking towards goal, and Spiros saw some extra room too and said, thanks a lot, Jai. And he's got his second, and he's 20th for the season. Amarantides, and that's 9 now for Deer Park. 9-3-57 to Spotswood 2-3-15.
Don't know what the Spotswood players are claiming something there, whether they thought it was touched or whether they umpire didn't call play on quick enough. I don't know, but it was at Orchard, you're right. They didn't give enough. They give him too much space to run around there, actually, young Spiros.
Well, George was walking more towards goal there. You would think, okay, get the 5 metre gap there between he and Spiros, but go more towards Spiros. Don't go away from him.
Yeah, I don't know the call there, but I don't know what they're appealing to the umpire for. But it doesn't matter. The goal's on the board.
It stands as Boyd now injects himself into the ruck. He says, I'm the captain. I've got to do something about this. And he goes long for home. But getting back, one of the premier fullbacks in the comp, Tim Quick, takes the mark. And Deer Park once again ready to threaten through Bruin. And his short ball finds Stankovic, marking in front of Matthew Dumbledon. Ball now right half back at the Westgate end. Short ball's okay too. So Williams hasn't seen a lot of it today. Short to Houlihan on the half volley. Oh, exquisite skills to keep that one in, Ryan Houlihan. Against the odds, too. He was outnumbered about 3-1. And he's able to eventually concede the ball over the line as Tom Langlands came in. But nice work from Ryan Houlihan, though.
A couple of scores. Boys Mount Lakes 2-1, 13. Caroline Springs 3-8-26.
He's moving well, Ryan Houlihan. Obviously, looks like he's injury or semi-injury free at the moment, which is a great sign for the Deer Park Football Club.
Speaking of the devil, there he is again, getting the handball received and the handball out to Stankovic to release him coming through the middle. Wanted Perton Smith, didn't take it, but at the feet there was Mayum. And now Perton Smith on the end of this chain. He should run into an open goal. 25 out, no mistake at all. And he's got two, JPS, and he joins McHarg and Amarantides as the multiple goal kickers today. 10-3-63 Deer Park. Spotswood 2-3-15.
I think those floodgates have started to open. Albion 4-2-26, Port Colts 2-1-13.
Put on a young Mayum there. The young brigade there, was it Plant, the other one you called Louis, I think, on the other
Great
end
Plant.
Of that, that handball.
Yeah, the last
drill there to give it off. Yeah, to give it off to Perton Smith. Two of the young Lions coming through the system here. Very impressive.
Geez, how promising is that, though?
Yep.
That was just Perton Smith's second disposal of the quarter, too.
Oh.
Yeah. Still so dominating, though, isn't he?
Disappointing.
Yeah, still hitting the scoreboard. That's all that matters. So, from
well, here we go.
He's
here,
Jazz. Okay.
He's got shit with you now, Willow. He's going, I'll get a few more just to shut us up.
Off to Cooper. He wants Kwame, and he read it nicely.
Too strong.
And Sam Wood's thinking, why me?
Yes. Too strong.
Well read at the back, too. Didn't even have to put body on Wood at all. Just mentally knew where to stand, Kwame, with that kick from Cooper.
He's not going to... He was going to go around. The umpire said go around, but he ain't going to go around anymore, Kwame.
I don't think it's going to matter what angle he's on, Tom.
I'll tell you what.
He's on about a 178-degree angle now, and he'll kick it as if he's directly in front.
He knows the camera there. He knows the radio's there.
We mossed him. We mossed him. We got him.
Should have gone around. Should have gone around more.
One behind only to Kwame. His first blemish for the day. Oh, I dare say it'll be his only one. 10-4, 64 to 2-3-15. But what a quarter for Deer Park. 6-1-2.
How many players from Deer Park do you see sort of go to ground, or do you see getting knocked off a marking contest? Not many at all. They are so strong in that area.
Hard to find as we get the ball now to left half back for Spotswood. Butler goes off, wants big Gus Millen, but he's just outbodied easily in the end by Bullen. Despite the fact there's about 30 centimetres in height difference, Bullen comes back
tackle.
In, but Bullen came back nicely. Bullen came back strong. He saw fire. And he put it out nicely too. But then he did the old Ruckman's curse, played on straight to a teammate. Was Tom Langlands, but he was about standing half a centimetre away from
it. It was much Langlands' fault for calling for it.
Probably too.
Yep.
As the Ruckman usually has, it's pretty gullible. As Deer Park now switch play over to the Social Club side. They're at left half forward now. Short ball, Plant once more, and now Suki with an opportunity to kick a goal against his former club.
Jeez, he'd love to kick this one, Suki. He would love this.
Love to see his reaction if he does too, Tomsey.
Yeah, no, I think he'd be pretty cool. Don't think he's going to... He's not one for a lot of attention here, Ahmed Suki, but he obviously moved from Spotswood this year over to arch rivals in Deer Park.
He's only really ever known Spotswood in terms of his football life, juniors and seniors. But can't get one against his old side that time. Just the left one behind.
And he is a backman. He is a backman. Sorry, Sooks.
5-65 to 2-3-15. Suki didn't play in the round one clash, so... Chop it a bit, I'm sure, during the week when he saw his name on the side to take on his old team this week. Margin now at 50 points in favour of the reigning premiers. That margin threatened to grow even more. As the ball now is brought towards centre wing on the social room side, Marks. Aaron Handball couldn't get it towards Fairley that time. Deer Park once again, this time Ismail gets the kick to Perton Smith. He'll try and take on the would-be tackler there in Davis. Gets around him eventually, and he finds Houlihan between left half forward and the left forward pocket with Elliot manning the mark. Houlihan trying to say, get back over it. Short in, and it's Bullen again.
Houlihan, Bullen, they've turned back the clock. I reckon they've said, bugger these kids coming through the system here at Deer Park. How about let us stand up? Let us don't forget who we are.
The last two AFLs, former AFL players standing, aren't they?
Yeah, well, they are. And I tell you what, they're absolutely turning on a show, both of them today.
So the coach, Bullen, for his second. And it's a sweet hit off the boot as well. Oh, just to the right. Looked good. But didn't end up being good enough. 1-1 for Mark Bullen. 10-6 for Deer Park, 66. 2-3-15 for Spotswood. They're just desperate for this second quarter siren to go as Dumbledon, Nathan, short to Tom Langlands. And his short kick now outside of defensive 50 is okay as well to Marks. Jason Marks, lateral again. Nathan Dumbledon right in front of the caravan. Left half back. Again, very stagnant play here for Spotswood, and another backwards kick too. So now they're back to around about 20 from their own goal and just going to play a little bit of hot potato with it.
Dumbledon once more. Turn and go, turn and go.
Now he tries to create a little bit of spark as Farley has the mark. His kick is short too and honours the lead of Butler.
Give them credit, Spotty. They are trying something a little bit different. Just in the end, it's working probably up to about 65% of the work,
Farley.
Correct work, and all of a sudden it's getting turned over.
This next kick's the important one across half forward. It's where they're struggling all day.
Yep.
Murray Boyd can't kick it to himself.
No.
Exactly right. He goes high and long to left half forward. Marking target down there is the shortest man of the lot, and Tippett. He got a hand to it and then saw it go over the line out of bounds. No Buttigieg Clark to kick it to. Very huge injury concern.
Yeah.
It's that arm. Right. I'd hear more of an update from it from him later on. We dare say he won't take any further part in the game the way he looked.
No, he won't be able to. He won't be able to anyway. He went didn't even come across through the interchange. So no, he's definitely got a serious arm injury there.
So from the throw in, Deer Park have the footy, but they might lose it here. Davis to Boyd. Finds a little bit of space. Gets around a couple. Bruin the last one there. However, the handball to Butler wasn't so pretty. Brown catches him. And Deer Park get the quick kick away. Stankovic on his far. That was Tippett. And he's got some time to steady and go for goal here. And he decides not to in the end. It was a good pass. And they should be able to get their third on the board belatedly. They're only 10 metres out directly in front with this kick. And it'll be taken by Lachlan Fairley.
Well done, young Tippett. Good work. Bit of quicker ball movement going inside the 50 there, Willow.
Yes. Their best forward play, I thought, for the quarter was the Jai Orchid kick off the ground.
Yes.
That's the quickest they've moved it all day.
Yeah.
And it was a kick off the ground. That's the thing. They've got to move it quicker.
Yep.
I don't know how many times I have to say it.
Lose count eventually as Fairley does kick truly and gets Spotswood's first goal of the second term at the 24-minute mark. 3-3-21 to Deer Park, 10-6-66, margin back to 45 points.
Boardy, Murray Boyd just in that a little bit. You're right what you said before, Willow. He can't get it and kick it to himself further up the ground, but as much as he can get into this game, they've got him across half-back line at the moment. Not a bad thing just to stem the flow of the Deer Park goals.
Millen back in ruck. He got the tap down to the right spot. There was no one there. Eventually Nathan Dumbledon got there, didn't get possession, and got slung away from the footy, so free kick.
And slow movement.
And again, slow movement. Now he goes for Tom Langlands against Summers. Summers appealing for the free kick, umpire says no good at all. Fairly good kick in. Pope has got it, and he'll go back and line up, Ben Pope.
He's confident in kicking this one, Popey. Should be a training drill. Many shots at goal, I would dare say, from around that area. What's the... Tommy Langland stats at the moment, Willow?
Tommy Langland's 5 this quarter, 10 for the match.
He's
2 marks.
Lukey Summers going with him at the moment, doing a good job. Really, when he's going forward, Tommy Langland's, Luke Summers really pushing hard with him then to get to that second, third contest, so it was good.
So Ben Pope will come in. Could have gone to 40 metres if he wanted to, but it let us go right on the paint, and he's got it nicely too. He loved it as soon as it left his boot. So he's got two. And Spotswood string two together. 4-3-27. Deer Park 10-6-66. Margin back to 39 points.
That's a lot better. That's a little bit better coming in forward, going in. Nice finish by Popey. And the confidence they need too, you know, to get now, they've really just got to focus on this next one. Trying to get the three in a row. Just focus, nothing more before half time than just one more goal here from the centre break. Go for broke. Everything's to gain here for Spotswood.
Byron Dennison puts the ball in the air again. Millen back in ruck for Spotswood. Gets the tap down. Just misses Tom Langlands, but doesn't miss Butler. And he gets it off quickly to Norton. Josh Norton, long to the top of the square. Just eludes the marking target in fairly. He's had to go down there in the absence of Buttigieg Clark. Over for a throw in. That was a bit more promising the last couple of minutes for Spotswood, though. And that was a good centre clearance.
Yeah, it was. It's something they've lacked all day. The Spotswood team, but the centre clearances and quick ball movement is good. Good sign.
Milliman Greenhoff again. Greenhoff just out body in Milliman that occasion. Stankovic gets the loose ball. Quick kick away, almost marked by Butler. The crumbs gather beautifully by Houlihan. Very exquisite. Off to Plant. Worried out of it by four Spotswood players. Fogarty, one of them, along with Butler. And Fogarty's kick, though, smothered. Butler goes in again for another good effort. That was his third in as many seconds there. Very nice work from Butler. Unfortunately, the kick letting down, missing the target in Fairley. Mark taken by Brown at the back for Deer Park. Called to play on now. Fairley creeps up towards him, but Brown still gets the kick away. Wants Greenhoff. Plant flew up as well. At the full of it now, Greenhoff gathers. Brought down by Big Gus. And will get a ball up around left half forward for the Woodsman.
Coming away a few inches in the ruck today, Scotty Greenhoff. But Millen.
Anyone wounded with a 210 centimetre giant to go against. He taps that one down to Nathan Dumbledon to the top of the square. Ryan lurking for Spotswood. Just harassed out of it in the end. Still a live ball. Oh, quick kick away. Smothered. Goal to Spotswood. The attempted kick away by the Deer Park defence. Quickly smothered. And a great gather. Was that Davis who got the goal? Spencer Davis, I think, was just there in the goal square.
Was it Davis or Fairley?
Well, might have been Fairley.
I think it was Fairley.
Yeah,
Lockie Fairley.
Sure.
Yep. Probably Davis Fairley was the one who smothered it.
Yep.
So we'll give it to Lockie Fairley. That's three in a row now to the Woodsman. Some promise coming to halftime. 5-3-33 to Deer Park 10-6-66.
Well, exactly what we spoke about moments ago, guys. They needed to get that three in a row. This is going to give them a little bit of confidence going into halftime. Take the scoreboard out of it at the moment. Spotswood, you just got to concentrate on playing the way you have the last 10 or so minutes. It's been good. Quick movement.
So back in the middle, can they sneak a fourth one in before half time? Tom Langlands will certainly want to try and hope so. He gets the clearance out towards his brother and Will Langlands, but the siren just beats them. But a good, promising last couple of minutes there for the Woods, but after what's been a pretty dismal day for them, and they've cut the margin back from 51 points at the 21 quarter minute mark of that term to just 33 at the main change. 10-6-66 Deer Park. And Spotswood 5-3-33. And we'll take a break and we'll come back with a full halftime summary. More around the ground score updates from Kevin Hillier and plenty more food to be eaten as well. Thanks to the fine folk here at the Spotswood Football Club Canteen here on your WRFL Match of the Day, Division 1, 88.9 Win FM.
G'day, Sean Sowerby from 7 News. Be sure to stay tuned to 88.9 Win FM for all of your local WRFL football. And for all the latest AFL news, be watching 7 News live at 6. Proud sponsors of 88.9 Win FM.
Bridgestone means confidence, and that's how you'll feel about your car after visiting Bridgestone's Tyre and Service Centres St Albans and Hoppers Crossing. Whether it's new wheels or mechanical repairs for your sedan, performance vehicle or four-wheel drive, Bridgestone's Tyre and Service Centres St Albans and Hoppers Crossing will keep your family safe and on the move. Bridgestone's Tyre and Service Centres St Albans and Hoppers Crossing. Now that's confidence. Visit us online at bridgestone.com.au.